What I'm going to talk about are the audio settings and the video connections. And I have my notes over here to the right. So that's if I, my little head goes that way, that's what's going on. So Janet talked about this, and on my screen, I'm on a Mac desktop, and on my screen, if I wiggle the mouse, new tools appear along the bottom. And I see in the lower left-hand corner, I see the microphone, the little microphone that says mute, which I'm not going to mute myself. And then I see a little camera that says stop video. Right next to the little microphone and the little camera, there are these little, they're like tops of arrows. They're pointing up. And if you, let's do the microphone first. If you click on the little tiny arrow just to the right of the microphone, you're going to get a window. And these are all different settings that you can play with if you want. Okay. What you want to do to test your microphone is you click on that little arrow and you go up to audio settings. You can follow along. That might be the best thing. Why doesn't everybody click on audio settings? Does everyone find that? Thumbs up if you find it. I see one thumb up. Okay. So here it is. You can see right now, if you have the settings window open, I can see, since I'm talking, I can see my input mic level going up. And it starts, it's red and then it's green and then it's red and it's green. And you can also adjust the input volume. And if you're not sure, everybody could hear us, but on your device, you have speakers, and you can test the volume of the speaker to make sure that if you have a problem with your sound, you can do a little troubleshooting and see is my speaker not working? And you can test your speaker by clicking on that little button that says test speaker, and then you can talk into the speaker and you will hear a tone, and that will tell you if your speakers are working or not. So that is testing your audio. Now if you go to there, the next thing is your little video camera, and yours should say start video. There's also a little teeny tiny arrow on that you can click on. And you'll see that you can choose a virtual background if you want. Let me show you that. If I go- Maybe
Roxanne has a question. I'm gonna just, sorry to interrupt. I'm gonna unmute you. Okay. Do you wanna mute yourself, Roxanne, and ask your question?
Roxanne.
I just wanted to say that I'm using a phone this morning, so my choices won't be the same as a laptop.
Okay. Great, okay. Good to know.
So the option with a phone is not as many as a laptop, but I'm
But if you click on that little arrow, you have some choices. On my computer, it says FaceTime high definition camera, which is built in. And also if you look up at your computer, you can see that little green light. You should have a little green light on your device that shows you that your camera is active. And if you if that ever goes on and you didn't turn it on yourself, somebody is spying on you. But I won't get into it. That's your camera. Then underneath says choose virtual background. I do want to show you my green screen, but if you click on virtual background, okay, I'm going to try to share this particular screen with you. Let's see if we can do this. Share. Do you see me and the Golden Gate Bridge behind me?
Yes.
Give me a thumbs up if you do. Yes. Okay. So in this setting, we have the Golden Gate Bridge. We have these green leaves. We have outer space. We have the northern lights, which is cool, but it's a little distracting. And then we have the beach. or we have none. And I want to show you something. My husband, do you see this green sheet in back of me? My husband got this for me. It's called a green screen. And you can see it's not perfect. It's like I have it set up on top of two guitar cases and a ladder. It's very, very wiggly. And then I took this green screen, which is just like a green piece of basically thick paper, and put it over there. And it makes your these virtual backgrounds a little bit more effective. So I'm going to put myself back on the Golden Gate Bridge.
You can also upload other ones by clicking on that little plus sign to the top right. You can upload your own photos.
There we go, right there. Okay. Yeah, can you see this screen here? Okay, good. So so we are in virtual background. There are a whole bunch of other settings we can do. I'm going to look at audio video here. This is another cool one I wanted to show you. In video under settings, this is a great little trick. Touch up my appearance. Now you wonder why everybody on TV looks so great. This is why. They click this little box, and there's all kinds of filters that you can download, which I haven't done, that smooth your face out, make your lips look bigger and all kinds of things. Your eyes look bigger. But if you click, but I think everybody can use a little help, right? So I would click on this touch up my appearance button too. And let's see, what else is there here that is important? I think it's mainly the audio. Oh, here we go. So you can see I'm testing my mic to make sure that my mic is working. And I can also test my speaker. I wonder what happens if I do this. Let's try it. Did you hear that?
No.
Okay. All right. It played a little song for me and I could hear it. So now I know my speakers are working. All righty. Good. All right. Let's see if there's anything else on my notes that I wanted to look over.
I have a question.
Yes.
Once you've hit touch up my appearance, where do you go from there? I'm there now. Like, how
just,
do I get?
Just turn it on.
It's on. Now what do I do?
Like... now you can exit. You can.
No, I mean, how do I make my skin smoother? I mean, where are those options?
No. It's on. It's already on.
Oh.
You just made yourself beautiful.
This is the best it's gonna get, right?
Yeah.
Can I ask a question?
Yeah.
When I try to change the virtual background, it says your processor does not recommend specification for virtual background.
Okay, so I would not do that. What kind of computer are you on?
I'm on a MacBook Air, but it's 5 years old, so.
So it's telling you, use this at your own peril.
Okay.
You can try it and see if it works.
Janie and Tyrell, I'm on a MacBook Air, and it's this year, just bought, and I got that same message.
Oh.
So I just am not going to probably do that background stuff.
Well, but, you could try.
If I want to use my own microphone, I just put it into my computer. I've never done that, so I don't know.
Jamie?
Yeah, you can absolutely do that. There are microphones that you can buy that are called USB microphones. And what you do is you go to your sound settings. And so if you go to your on my desktop in the lower left-hand corner is my little microphone that says mute or unmute. Next, that little tiny arrow next to it, you can go to audio settings. And I'm going to try to share this screen because this is a little tricky. Here we go, share.
Okay.
So here's the settings. Can everybody see settings?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Alrighty. So, now, along this list, we're going to go to audio settings. So I'm going to click on this audio. And right here. Mm-hmm. And this is where you test your speaker, and your microphone. But for music, it's a little different than a meeting. Now, Zoom was developed for corporate meetings and mainly for businesses. So when you're doing it for something like music, that you need to change your settings. And so this is just for a music application. What you would do is you would go to this advanced button right here. I'm going to click on it. And you can see my settings are already different than yours if you're following along.
I don't see the advanced button.
Yes, the advanced button. What you want to do is these things, suppress persistent background noise, is a very good thing if you're just in a meeting where people are talking. But when you're doing music and you have a guitar and you're singing into the microphone, you want this to be disabled. The default setting is auto. But since I do island tunes, I have it disabled. The same thing with suppress intermittent background noise. This is a good thing to have on when you're in a normal meeting and people are talking and discussing ideas, and you know, it's like being in an office building. But I have my setting, usually it's on auto, which is perfect for what we're doing right now. But for music, I have it on disabled. Echo cancellation is still on auto. So those things really help the quality of the sound when you have something like a guitar and your voice.
And that was all by hitting on the bottom, the advanced block?
I'm going to go back. Okay. We opened up our settings. And honestly, think of it this way. If you're in an application, every single application has settings. So it doesn't matter whether you're in Facebook. Facebook has settings. Google has settings. Zoom has settings. Everything has settings, and settings are the keys to the kingdom. They will let you be the ruler of your digital domain. So find settings whatever device you're on. Keep poking around till you find settings, and here are all the settings that we can play with. And right now we're in audio.